There was a time when things were simple, days were happy, and I sat up in my room looking down at the back porch, out across the fields, wondering what my life would be like in years to come. I was to follow in my sister's steps. School in Atlanta. Everything was ready. The acceptance set. I would move in at Georgia State and make it my home for at least a few years. But things didn't happen that way. The farm is a relic, a ruin, a bucket full of dirty water, tears caught welling up from the pain of this place. The pain of hate withered, toiling beneath the ground, pushing up from graves like skeleton coffins coming back to life. I've forgotten what it was like to wake up in those chains. I've made amends by leaving behind those last happy days sinking into the earth. When I was a boy, my father bought a wooden hot tub with planks held together by large rings. The wood would swell, joined by grooves, making a pool to rest the body. When Dad put together this tub, he filled it with water, cold from the well, and I jumped inside, eager to swim. Paddling about, soon coming out, chilled. The tub never worked well and soon fell into disrepair. Another relic, another ruin to sit around and become part of this place, the extended landscape of tractors and machines and other broken things left to wither. Years after I moved away, Dad cut down the planks and made the tub into a garden bed where Mother tends to flowers. "Where did you plant flowers this spring?" I asked my mother recently.
"Out there in the hot tub," she replied.
And I could see in her eyes the joy of growing plants and taking old things to make something new. I remember a plant in the house with leaves green like watermelon stripes and a single dead strand hanging down the side, sad, dry, a part of life transformed, dying. I thought, that is me. I thought, I see myself in that plant. And so I continued, this is life. That plant is everything. That plant is God. It seemed odd, as if something had taken hold among the smothering haze of family, that there might be something more than what tradition taught. Once again, I thought, that plant is God. I walked to the mailbox, collected a new issue of Rolling Stone, flipping through pages of articles and interviews, music, news, all the things teenagers do to find themselves. I spread out the magazines across the bedroom floor, looking at the Calvin Klein men and wanting more. Like the time when my best friend spent the night and we wrestled on the bed. Teenage horseplay teasing, my hand reaching for his crotch. I didn't mean any harm. He pulled away in a violent jerk, backing into my dresser where an antique glass jug, a relic I had dug up in the barn, came crashing to the floor in a waterfall of pennies and dimes. "You'd better not have grabbed me on purpose," he chimed, eyes sharp in defense. "I didn't mean to," I whined. Though I did not regret the attempt, for it was the closest I had ever been to touching another man's cock. The jagged jug, like an eloquent blade, stayed on my dresser until after I moved away and my room became a relic, like the rest of the farm. I look back on those days before the exile and think about that place, how it is part of who I am, how, even then, I was looking deeper, how the fields and streams, the plants, the trees, nature's temple, taught me how and who to be. It was a time when things were simple, days were happy, and I sat up in my room, looking down at the back porch, out across the fields, wondering what my life would be like in years to come. And here I have traveled far, leaving behind the last happy days. Yet still I remember them.